It's the way that you know what I thought I knew. Like the beast in my heart.
Redra, challenge! It's not a PewDiePie reference, okay? In this video, I'm going to do an old artwork mine that I did in when I was 11 years old. Right now I'm 19. And it's like, oh, I evolved so much! So much, guys! It was because of a lot of training, hard work, all of those things. I recommend a lot if you're going to follow the artwork to keep just pushing yourself through it, because it's worth, you're going to make it. I believe in you. Again, I'm going to send a kiss. You guys are beautiful. And I'm thinking about calling you guys Mina-san. I like that word. I know it's Japanese reference, but I like it. Like, hello Mina-san. I know it's a part of me that's a taco thing, but I would like it. This is the artwork that I'm going to change. It's like, his name is Ichiba. It was a mix between Ichigo and Simba. While going to the drawing, I went to do a different pose, because it was like, oh, I'm standing in front of you. Nice. Nobody cares. I tried to make him look more powerful, like, oh, I'm here. I'm a big Kang. I can do whatever I want. And I was trying to change a lot of his body, because like, I make him standing or sitting. And I was like, oh, let's make him standing so I have more body to do, more body to draw and paint. Great. Training a lot. I did color base and then I start putting background, but just some simple background, nothing too out of taste. And more base in the lion. I'm starting doing the light, because light is pretty important. It will be dependent according to your background. If you want to have a good light, please do first your background and then the character. It will be harder to do first the character and then the background, because it'll be like, oh, the light is here, but it's here, but it's not here, and here. And from this, after putting the light everywhere, I will start just detailing and fixing things that I think that not looking great, like the front legs. It's just not the size. The shoulder would be bent down, not that up, you know, not that close to the neck. And I start in detailing the fur, and I always tend to start with the face. Because the face is the place that most people will look at it. People will try to see, oh, that face is so beautiful. People won't care if the leg in the background is not looking so good, but the face needs to be 100% okay. Needs to be 100% fine. And of course, if it's a serious drawing, like for a company, you need to render everything. Don't do the back leg in whatever way, you know. Do it with calm and patience. Everything's going to flow fine. Oh, okay. When I do fur, I try to do it looking like one part by one part. And I try to fix, oh, this is taking light or this is shadow. I will divide in between those two. And in the shadow, I will divide one more time by, is this really dark or is it reflecting something? I start to think a lot while I'm drawing, and I'm right now using a reference that I like this artist so much. I love her. It's called Karade in online social medias. And she helped me a lot. I do this a lot, to see somebody artwork and try to what I can take from it that may help me. And I'm doing this. I saw, oh, okay, I need to do the fur like this, oh, I need to do the shadow like this, the lights come from here. Everything, you can get help from other artist artwork. I recommend a lot you to do it. So, I'm trying to fix everything, because in the nose I saw that I did the perspective wrong, the eye and the head in one perspective and the nose was in another, so I was like, this one perspective. Yeah, bitch, choose one. You cannot have two perspectives. And then I choose and I'm detailing even more the fur. It's really important, and always try, if your light is too intense, like in this artwork, not too, but intense, you need to make the fur even brighter. Even brighter. In the dark, darker. Make it be that pretty separated. And after that, after making even more fur, I try to make the light in the left side even brighter, like I said. Because it will give a be like a feature, you know? You will see the background behind the charger here, really close to you. The more you put contrast in your artwork, the more people will see, oh, I can see that silhouette right here. That's awesome. I will keep doing that. Awesome, guys. And I start using reference for anatomy because I don't know where each muscle is. You don't need to know where each muscle is. You just need to pick a study and then trying to do it. From time to time, you start to see, oh, I know that's a muscle here and here and here and here and here, 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 here. So it will be all fine. You don't need to know everything from the start. Reference will help you a lot. And people don't like to use. They try to do a new artwork in OC Charter without even using one reference because it needs to be from your imagination. No! Just no! Nothing's totally created. You always use some reference, even from your brain. Your brain cannot create something that you had never seen. Okay, I got a bit excited. I was talking too loud. And with the detailing even more. But part of the process be after you do the lights and shadows, you are just going to detail whatever thing, the place that you need to. And try to render the place that you want the people to focus. Don't render a part that you don't want people to focus. Always think, oh, I'm going to look here, I want people to look here, and I'm going to do that place look beautiful. Yeah. Yeah. And to do the fur, you don't do one by one. You try to give give people to see that like it's one by one, but it's like, oh, I just put a stroke here and it's looking like this. Yes, you don't need to do stroke by stroke, you just need some thicker strokes that will look like fur. Just doing fur by fur, it will take a lot of work. There's no need for it. Not even company will want that type of artwork. You can even use texture from images. You can search dog texture fur and Google will give you some reference and you can use and put that in your artwork if you really want realistic fur. Or you can use a brush. I'm glad that nobody asked me which brush I use. Because everybody's like, oh, which brush you use? I hope that's a good brush because I cannot make the same as you because my brush is not that great. Not a brush, it's myself, kids. And while you're doing the background, going back up, going back to the artwork. While I do the background, I try to do some trees, clouds, and a blue, beautiful. And I think that's good for give contrast to the orange, red character. And I added another layer of color dodge and soft light, if I remember. Yes. Good memory, good memory. And I start doing all these trees, looking at anime reference. So I was like, oh, it's not getting the way that I want. What can I do to improve and make it get the way I want? So I was like, ah, oh, use texture. I start using texture to get the tree the way I want it. And always, it is in the background, so it's going to get blue. I know the trees are green, but it's going to get a lot of blue mixed on it. And I think that's a good way to show how in the background something is. And the more to the sides, the more to the border the painting is, the less contrast it needs to have. Because if something in the border have contrast, it's going to take the attention from the charter in the center. You need to do it like, oh, here. Here it's going to have focus, and this other part's not going to have focus. So everybody's looking to look. Everybody's going to look here, yeah. And I added another layer of screen mode in Photoshop. And it's like to give, oh, there is blue a bit in his neck. Another part of his body, like the back leg and the ribs. I use the screen mode too. Hope you guys enjoyed. This is the evolution that I made. And if I can, you can. Never leave your dreams behind. I believe in you. If you want any tip of drawing, if you want any hack that I can pass, just comment below. I'm going to help you. I love helping people. You're awesome. Leave the like, leave the comment, subscribe, hit the bell button. And I'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye!